Hi guys, it's Gordon here at Avolites. I'm going to take you through working with timing syntax inside Titan. Timing syntax can be used when you're building up just playbacks and when you're building up cuelists as well. Timing syntax is a nice, easy way of being able to work with time information in your program. Say I'd like this to be recorded as a cue, and I'd like those beams to be in that color as well. Every time I bring this playback up, I want it to have a 2 second fade in time, but I want that color information to have a 4 second fade in time. With those beams selected, I can say the time for those fixtures and then tap color on my attribute bank to be 4, enter. I could then also say time 2, enter. This is going to give the console an instruction to put in the programmer of the time for this cue to be 2 seconds and the time for those fixtures that I currently have selected color of 4 seconds. Now if I record, this time I'm going to record by fixture onto a playback. I can clear that information out of my console. Just give those beams some new color information so that you can see it happening. If I bring that playback up, you can see that they fade in over 2 seconds, but that color information will fade in over 4 seconds. Building up cue lists, it might be necessary for you to use some complicated times as well. Even building up cue lists, if I say time 3, enter, that's going to give the cue that I'm building a time of 3 seconds. If I say time 3 and 4, it's going to give it a fade in time of 3 seconds and a fade out time of 4 seconds. Every time you press time and a number on Titan, this little guide comes up. On the Titan 1 interface, it's on the far left-hand side, but on a normal console, it will be on this space of your console screen. This guides you through all the different options that you can use this timing syntax for. I'm now going to tackle this last one because it's one of my personal favorites. Say I'm going to make that same kind of look that I made before once again. But this time I want a overlap to be over that color information. I'm going to say time 2, enter. I'm then going to say the time for those fixtures color to be 4. I'm then going to put a delay time. So I'm going to say at 0 through 5 second intervals. Tapping enter to finish my command, I'm then going to record that onto a playback. Giving those spot beams some new instructions so that you can see the effect again. I'm going to fire it. And now you can see that there is an overlap currently happening across these fixtures. A delay time. Having a look inside this particular cue, I'm going to tap View Cue. Now in my context menu, I'm going to change to time information. You can see all of this information is what that syntax has just entered. If I wanted that particular look, then I've got to go through and enter all of this information myself. Using this timing syntax, I can make the console do some more hard work for me. Thanks for watching and tune into the next one.